We will start with the hardware setup. Connect the 5-volt output to one of the button pins and ground to the pins beside it through 10K resistor. From the input, wire pin 2 from Arduino to the button pin after the resistor. Let's go to Arduino IDE and look at the script. Begin with defining pin 2 as an input and start a serial port with baud rate of 19200. You can go higher than this, but it depends on your specification. And for the loop, we will read the button input with this value and string for data to send. If we press the button, or if the button is greater than 0, we will send the data 1. Else, if button is 0, we will send the data 0. We will delay 10 milliseconds before sending it to the serial, and then we will flush the serial, which we gonna send the data before we can loop back to this code. Now onto Unity, I have set up a simple scene where the player jumps to avoid randomly spawning spike. We will use the Arduino button to make the player jump. Here if I play, I got error because I haven't plugged my Arduino to my computer. Let's plug it in. There you go, now we got no error. And let's see in the player. Here is the player script. We will start by writing this. To basically use the system ports. And here we have the jump velocity and serial port data stream equal new serial port from COM6 with 19200 baud rate. We have string value to read the data and bool to check if the player has jumped once. We also have rigid body to calculate the player physics and gravity. In the start void, we will put rigid body 2D to the RP, and we open the data stream with data stream.open. In the update, we have value equal data stream.readline, which will read the data stream line, which is 0 and 1 in the Arduino script. And if jump equals true and integer parse value is greater than 0, we will make the player jump with applying the jump velocity to rigid body.velocity y. And I also print the value right here. And this is for the jump, so the player cannot jump infinitely. In condition enter, this is when the player can enter the platform under, and this is exit, where the player is not on the floor, which means he's on air. Statement that won't allow him to jump. Jump equal false, and it's also stand here that the player cannot jump while it's false. I will put or statement input dot get button down space, and it one more brackets, and jump equal true. And that's basically it. This is the value from the serial Arduino, and sometimes the system.io.port is not available. You need to go to edit, project settings, go to player and in API compatibility level, and just this .NET 2 framework, not the standard one. I just change it to standard. It will compiling script again. And here, if you use .NET standard 2.1 or another version that is standard, you will get an error for the ports. That's why you need to put the .NET to framework, and that will just fix everything. Let's try it out. The unit is, the Arduino is right here. Let's first try with the spacebar. I need to set up the button. That should be in project settings and input manager. It's right here. Jump. So let me just use the jump. Let's start it again. As you can see, I can jump both with spacebar and Arduino button. As you can see, the latency here is really low. You might not see it printed correctly as one, but that is the simplest way how you can connect your Arduino button to Unity game with the system.io.ports and serial port data stream. That's everything for this video, and thank you for watching.